I am going to wait 2 minutes to make sure that I'm live. Every time I say I'm going to do a Facebook Live, I always remind myself too late to bring my other phone and test to make sure that I'm live. But I'm just going to go with it because I'm getting the notification that I'm live. So hello everybody, happy Monday. I hope you guys had a really great Thanksgiving. As you noticed, I was not in the group saying hello. The truth is, I think you guys can all relate. When you go away and you're at relatives' house, especially when you have to travel to somebody else's house, it's just nonstop, especially when you're going to see, which most of us are if we're traveling over the Thanksgiving or Christmas weekend, you're traveling to people's houses that you haven't seen in a long time. And so there's just no downtime and it is what it is. But you probably, if you were watching me on Instagram, which so many of you, that's how we connected, you noticed, and I have to share this because it's a lot of what I'm trying to help all of you with. Steve and I were able to really stay true to our commitment to really enjoy the holidays, really like enjoy the time with family, not be like obsessive, worrying about diet and calories and, you know, saying no to everything. But on the other hand, not completely destroying all the progress that we'd already made and not feeling like, you know, we were gonna gain weight that weekend or just even mentally just feel like we were off of our game. So it was really, really awesome to know we made a commitment to ourselves. We were going to work out that day before we left on Wednesday. We worked out every single day, even if it was for 10 or 15 minutes. We worked out every single day. We stayed true to our calorie goals. We enjoyed the holidays. And now we're back to take things up a notch. We're going to start our 24-hour fast today and go until tomorrow. Things are going really well. So today I want to make one point, and I know I did not announce I was doing a Facebook Live, so please forgive me, but I know most of you will catch this on the replay. So many of you are back at work today. But I have been seeing repeatedly this recurring theme with so many of you in the group, so many people who write into the podcast, so many people who follow me on Instagram and will private message me. And I just keep hearing this same, it's an attitude, it's a feeling that I see in women. I've certainly had it and I need to address it because it's something that if you ladies can get a handle on this, recognize it in yourself. Hey, Natalie, how are you? If you can recognize this in yourself and start to change your attitude, change your thought process. And let me just sidebar before I finish this. Those of you guys that are used to watching me know that I do this all the time. I start making a point and then I have to go, wait a second, let me clarify this, but I'm gonna do it anyway. When you're talking about behavioral change, it doesn't just happen overnight. I want you to know that I recognize that. I also wanna share with you that the behavioral changes I've made that are hugely impactful or are becoming hugely impactful in my life have not happened overnight. Quite often, it's like anything. Sometimes I've made a commitment to do something, I fall off the wagon, I get back on, I fall off the wagon, then I stay for a longer time. I maybe kind of fall off the wagon and then you get back on. The point is, just like with weight loss, as long as you're looking at whatever it is, like the scale, weighing yourself, as the point is happening over time, is that you're trending in the right direction in general, it doesn't matter if you have a hiccup, right? With behavioral change, you can't just watch this video and go, oh, okay, I haven't been doing this. Let me change that tomorrow. It's gonna happen over time. So I just wanna make sure that you know I understand that and I recognize it. And frankly, that's another reason why I started this group. And for those of you that are gonna be watching this video later on YouTube, join my group, A Year of You First. This is for accountability because we can all make a commitment, but there's going to be times when we are going to fall back into our old habits, fall back into our own belief systems, fall back into doubting ourselves. And that's when accountability and community and friends around you who have the same goals that you do, but also want to see you succeed, that's when that accountability and community is really gonna help you. When you share, like, guys, I'm having a down day. I blew it yesterday at Thanksgiving. I feel like I'm just a failure. Da-da. You share that with your community, you share that with your accountability partner, and they will get you back on track. Accountability is so key. So, what's the behavior issue that I'm talking about? And this might sound super simple to so many of you, but I guarantee you, 90% of you have an issue with this. You don't believe in yourself. You don't believe you can do it. You don't believe that you have the ability. You probably believe that success, whether it's in your fitness life, in your relationship life, your love life, whether it's in your work life, whatever it is, you probably have this very strong belief that you're not gonna get there. And if you can't get yourself from where you've been for so long, where you just accept, I'm overweight, I'm just this person, I'm this size, I've always been this way, I've tried every diet, it's not working. If you don't get yourself, and that's what you have to do, you have to get yourself to a place where you fundamentally, unwaveringly believe in yourself that you can do it, because you can. Doesn't mean you can do it overnight. It doesn't mean that it's not gonna take some ups and downs and some really hard work and focus and discipline, but you can do it, period. I can do it, you can do it. I've gotten to the point in my business life and in my fitness life where I finally have unwavering belief that I can do the greatest things ever. But for the longest time, I didn't have that belief. And so many of you don't believe you can get there. And that's why you continue to make excuses for yourself. That's why you continue to give yourself a hall pass. That's why you continue to self-deprecate. That's why you continue to say, oh, if I could do this, oh, I wish I could do this, oh, I hope I can do this, or oh, that would be nice. If you hear yourself saying that kind of stuff all the time, you're talking very passively about yourself, and you're just reinforcing in your brain that you don't believe you can do it. And I have to tell all of you that are listening, if you're listening here live in the group, if you're listening in the replay, if you're listening for you YouTubers that are gonna watch this later, if you are saying this kind of stuff and you think that it is not making an impact on your brain, and therefore, when it's making an impact on your brain, that it's not going to affect your future decisions, you're misleading yourself. If this is new to you, or if you hear things like positive self-talk versus negative self-talk, hi Diane, if you hear things like affirmations, if you hear things like what your brain hears, it's going to, you know, thought follows, let me see, what's the word? I'm messing up some of my sayings. What you think about, you bring about. Like, if you're listening and you hear me saying that stuff and you're like, oh my God, what is this stuff? Like, I used to be one of those people. I used to be one of those people when somebody would mention a Tony Robbins event and I'd go, oh my God, yeah, is that where you walk on fire? Guess who walked on fire? Guess who thought it was one of the coolest things ever? Guess who experienced walking on fire and realized why people go walk on fire and why Tony Robbins events change people's lives. Now, if you've been one of those people, I'm making a sidebar illustration here, that you think Tony Robbins events are weird and all of that, you know, it's just hogwash and it's, you know, voodoo, personal development stuff. Like, that's just weird, I don't have time for that. If you think it's weird, do you think I'm weird? Why are you in this group? Most of you that are in this group have chosen to be in this group because what I talk about and what I talk to resonates with you. And you want to follow my advice and you want to follow my guidance. So guess what? I'm one of those people. I'm one of those people that went to a Tony Robbins event. I'm one of those people that invests a lot of time and money into personal development. And it's made me a better person. And you're going to see me, a lot of you guys that have been following me for a while, you watch me go from being this person in corporate America who left, founded a business, the most unexpected entrepreneur on the planet, and I founded a profitable seven-figure business that I ran and beat all the odds for a woman-founded profitable seven-figure business that lasted longer than the 2 years most of them will typically last. And then I shut that company down and I started another company in January of this year, and I was at a profitable six-figure point in 30 days by myself. Why am I sharing that with you? Because I think I'm a badass? Well, maybe a little bit. No, maybe a lot. I'm sharing that with you to say, I never thought I could do any of that stuff. But I was able to do that stuff because I took a leap out of my comfort zone. It's the same thing with fitness and with weight loss. You have to start making some big leaps, and you have to stop worrying about what people think of you, and you have to start absolutely fundamentally believing in yourself. And if you're gonna let what somebody at your office says to you, or somebody in your family says to you, or somebody at a Christmas party says to you, shake you up and make you give up and give in, then you don't believe in yourself. And when you really, really, really believe in yourself, then all of those other little things, they just become like noise. They become like a little mosquito, and it's not gonna stop you. But you absolutely, I want you to start looking around at the people that you maybe look up to, that you respect, that you aspire to be like, whether it's in the business arena, whether it's maybe it's somebody in the relationship arena, maybe it's somebody in the fitness arena. Look at who they are. I'll give you some examples of people that are in my life that I love. Ashley Horner, badass fitness chick, okay? Chris and Heidi Powell, Whitney Jones. Look some of these people up. Many of you that follow me are probably already following some of these people. In the business space, Jasmine Starr. She's a great businesswoman. I bought some of her Instagram courses, some of her photography courses, and so on. Who else? Gary Vaynerchuk, obviously, is a friend of mine. Tony Robbins, I already mentioned. What's the common theme with all of those people? They're overwhelmingly successful, and most of those people are successful not only in their fitness lives, but they're obviously very successful in their business lives. None of those people care what other people think of them. They don't care. Ashley Horner is not walking around caring if people are talking about how many tattoos she has. She's living her life, living it out loud. She is muscular and fit, and there are some guys that'll make fun of her, some women that'll make fun of her, but she's doing her thing, and she's, you know, for lack of a better way of saying it, laughing all the way to the bank. Chris and Heidi Powell, they're doing what they do. Some people will poke fun of that and go, oh my God, you know, like there's people out there that will make fun of women just because they're muscular, which is so moronic. Gary Vaynerchuk, people will make fun of him, poke fun of him because he swears, because he does this, because he's, you know, speaking to, he's going and doing garage sale stuff on the weekends, but he's passionate about helping people. You know what? He's a overwhelming success. Whitney Jones gets criticized all the time for being too muscular, for being in fitness competitions, this, that, and the other. She's criticized for the way she mothers or doesn't mother, or that she's a, you know, single mom, whatever, with a business, and she has a gym. I mean, she gets criticized for all kinds of things.